Dear friends, using this 433 MHz radio controlled remote circuit, you can make different type of projects. You can implement it as a wireless controller for robotic projects, remote control car, control electrical device like light, fan, etc. I will make different videos with this RF remote control in my future videos. Today in this video, I am going to show you how you can make a long-range RF remote control transmitter and receiver circuit. At first, I will make the transmitter circuit. This is the circuit diagram of the transmitter. But for better understanding, I have made a special connection diagram with the practical parts. I think it is less complicated than the circuit diagram. You can make it easier. Please let me know your opinion in the comments. Is this type of connection diagram helpful for you or not? You need to make this transmitter part. Diode 1N4007. Ceramic capacitor 10 kPf. Electrolytic capacitor 100 mFd. Resistor 220 ohms, 470k LED. IC 7805. HT12E. Eighteen pin IC base, it is optional. Micro push button switch, push to on switch, 16 pin dip switch, four 33 MHz RF RX TX module for a transmitter. We need only TX module. And it is for receiver. Vero board, wire for antenna, 2 pin terminal block, female header pin, it is 5 volt power supply block. IC pin 1 to 8 is connected with dip switch. Pin 18 is connected with 5 volt supply and pin 9 is ground. IC pin 17 is connected to TX module data pin. Now insert all components into the Vero board. Connect them like connection diagram. The transmitter part is ready. Now I will make the receiver part and test them. Here is the connection diagram of receiver. You need to make the receiver part. Diode 1N4007, capacitor 10 kPf. 100 mFd, resistor 220 ohms, 47K, LED red 4 piece, LED yellow, LED green, IC7805, HT12D. Eighteen pin base, one push to on switch, sixteen pin deep switch, 433 MHz RF receiver module, two pin terminal block, header pin, Vero board and wire for antenna. This receiver circuit has also 5 volt regulator block. This IC is different. For transmitter we used HT12E, but here we are using HT12D. IC pin 1 to 8 connected to deep switch. Pin 18 is connected to 5 volt and 9 is ground. Pin 14 is connected to RF receiver module data pin. Insert all components and connect them. Now it is complete. Now our both circuits are ready. As an antenna for both circuits, I am using some hookup wire about 10 turns. You can use telescopic antenna for better result. For power, you can use 5 volt to 12 volt. I am using 9 volt batteries. Using this push button, circuit turns on. It is the power indicator. Here the green LED is power indicator. This yellow LED is indicates the transmitter and receiver is paired and it connected. Here you can see 8 switches. Turn on or off the same number of the switches in the both circuits. That means if this switch is on, then here should be on. It is for pairing with this particular transmitter with this particular receiver like a combination lock. It will very useful when you will use multiple transmitter and receiver within the same working range. Now, when I press this button, here in the receiver section, this pin becomes low and LED is indicating. Here we can operate up to 4 channels. So if you want to make a remote control car, then just use a L293D motor driver board and put input signals from here. I will make a different video about it. Its working range up to 100 meters with good antenna. I hope this video was helpful for you. Thank you for watching. See you again soon in the next video.